So this video is all about English font. Especially I keep choosing this particular font. Why? Because this particular font has lots of curves and twists and turns, which are both from left to right, right to left, top to bottom, bottom to top. And if you closely observe, all these letters are in 45 degrees. If you slice them in 45 degrees, they become two equal parts. So that means we are supposed to write English in 45 degrees. Remember, this is the basic rule of English font, writing English font, 45 degrees. And second thing is, whenever you are writing, remember, all these are supposed to be in the same line. Okay, same line. And if you are actually slicing them, you get a ROM, whatever, parallelogram. So these parallelograms should be parallel to each and every font, I mean letter. Each and every letter should be parallel to the previous letter. That's how they are supposed to be. So if you now look at the way how things fall in place, all the letters. A. B. C. D. E. F. G. H. I. J. K. L. M. N. O. P. Q. R. S. T. U. V. W. X. Y. Z. If you closely observe, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all these vertical lines are parallel to each other in each and every single letter. This is something which needs to be observed carefully, and you need to know, you need to understand what is the beauty in each and every letter. For example, P, if you take P, P can be written this way and it can be written this way. So this curve should be bigger and this one should be small, only then it looks beautiful. So there is a balance, there is a harmony in each and every letter. If you completely understand and look into each and every particular letter, there is a harmony and there is a grace, there is balance in each and every letter. These three qualities are supposed to be in each and every letter, and you are supposed to practice them thoroughly, so that whenever you are drawing any curve, your wrist will twist and turn accordingly. You don't have to struggle too hard. You automatically will get to know that this particular thing needs to be drawn this way. For example, when you are drawing a circle, it's okay. But whenever you are drawing a part of ellipse or part of circle, which is, it's not the straight way, but it is little turned. So it becomes very difficult how thin this particular ellipse should be. Such kind of thin lines, such kind of thin ellipse or circles can be easily drawn whenever you practice these kind of curves. So when you practice these exercises, this particular font, your life becomes easy in getting the curves falling into right and perfect shape. Okay, so never ever stop practicing these kind of exercises. They are the fundamental exercises which actually help your hand to have more control over your pencil. Good luck.